our next three are Naomi, and Colton. So, Naomi, I've never met you before. You seem like a very brave and patient and kind and maybe a little demented person to be with Alex for so long. So I didn't write anything about you. The only thing that Alex told me about you is that you're vegan and you run marathons.
That's true.
And my reaction was, what the fuck? I guess it's true to say opposites do attract. Because I'm sure Naomi would attest, Alex, the only thing bigger than your ego is your waistline. Naomi.
Naomi Wilcox!
Okay, these are really comfortable. I get it now. I get the Crocs now.
These are great. Oh my God. I'm never taking the tag.
I just want to say another round of applause for Kyle, the cutest. Cutest and most charismatic comedian here tonight, not the boyfriend. So for my first act, I'd like to do an impression. This is Alex farting in his sleep.
That's traumatized.
As you can tell, we've gotten pretty comfortable. Seen him at his worst. It wasn't always this comfortable. In the beginning, he tried to impress me. Like, for example, on our first date, he took me to a very classy, fine dining experience, also known as Rudford's Diner. it was fine. We sat in this tiny, like, low to the ground booth that was covered in, like, weird sticky stuff. And, the carpet hadn't been replaced since 1955. And ketchup bottles have way too many germs. But, one thing he forgot that was a crucial part of this date is that I'm vegan. And, all I could really order at this diner was some really oily potatoes and way too much black coffee. So after my third cup, I was super jittery and anxious and, caffeine. He's like, oh no, let's continue the date. Come on into my car and I'll take you somewhere. It's like real safe. The date never ends. It's so much fun. Then he basically proceeded to spill his guts about his dark, dark past and all the trauma he's gone through, on the first date, it's pretty normal. And then, then he proceeded to take me to probably the most stinky, polluted beach in San Diego, Fiesta Island. And he tried to get a weird first kiss in front of a painted rock that was painted as a turtle. Pretty romantic, if you ask me. So I'd like some credit for going on a second date with this. In the beginning it was, try to impress her, poop with the doors closed and hide your Legos under your bed along with your childhood trauma, because what grown man plays with Legos? But the chivalry is definitely gone after a year and some change. Now and for a good laugh, he just directly farts on my face. So, as you can see, being the girlfriend of a comedian, it definitely has its ups and it's a lot of downs. So, yeah.
Jesus!
Girlfriend of comedian. So when you have, like, sometimes you're having an intimate moment with your partner and something kind of embarrassing happens, right? And I'm being delicate because Kyle's in the audience, but you can imagine. So that kind of information, as the girlfriend of comedian, is now shared with thousands of people in your local community for profit. That's what I have to do. My private life is not private. But anyway, I do think, though, for a straight white man raised in a trailer park, he has pretty good habits. Like, he's fairly clean, you know? His apartment has more tea light candles than a Catholic church. He tries really hard to be British by imitating Paul Hollywood, and and I'm pretty sure if you took a sample of his blood, it would come back 90% positive for Twinings Black Tea by volume. And I think he loves Clorox wipes more than he loves news.
Buy a small one.
So I think his ideal day would probably be, you know, wake up at 5 a.m., aggressively scrub his toilet bowl for a few hours, and then use it for a few hours. There's nothing more satisfying than dirtying up something that's very clean. He spends a lot of time on that porcelain throne as well. But what Alex doesn't want you to know is he's actually kind of a softie. Yeah. As previously mentioned, he uses more hair product than any normal human should to achieve this effect. And he will make you snickerdoodles, even when it's if you're not on a diet and it's not your birthday. But in all seriousness, happy stupid late birthday party, you farthead, and I wish you the best of luck trying to find someone more forgiving than me if you fuck this up.